السلام ورحمة الله. Okay, guys, I will start this lab concerning the routing information protocol. You have the file that contain instructions, configure and analysis of dynamic routing protocols. And normally in this file, we have two parts, the RIP and the OSPF. For us, we will take first the RIP, routing information protocol. And inshallah, next week we will take the OSPF protocol. So we'll use Backtracer. Lab 7. So we open Backtracer. I will start it now here, then I will back to our lab to when it will be free to start the configuration. As we said, the routing information protocol, it is based on the distance vector or the number of hops. We'll use this topology. In which we have to add three routers, two switches, and three PCs. As you know, guys, if you need, we start with the physical topology. With the physical topology, we go to the home city, then corporate office, then the main wiring closet or the rack, in which we have to add three routers. Which router we use, guys? From router, we go to network devices, then routers, and we have the router. Which one? Yes. Okay, guys, the router 1941. And switches, this for the routers. Switches to 960, and for the computers we use PCs or laptops. So here we add the two routers 1941. Normally when I will add it, it will be added with the rack, or you add a rack, then you add this routers. I will add three routers. And two switches for the switches, and the same subcategory for the Ethernet, same category for the network device, and the subcategory switches. We have the switch to 960. I will add two switches then I will go to end devices to add three computers here for the three computers that you need a table I will add three PCs I will add another table in which I will put this PC and a third table for another PC. Then now what I do, the connection, which cable we use to connect a router with the switch before, or we start from computers. We start from computers, then we go to switch, and then from the switch to routers. So from the computer, which cable we use, I will go to the category connections from which we have here, which cable straight through. This is the console cable, copper straight through from the network card. Just here, I increase the size. The fast Ethernet of the computer to the switch. Switch one or switch two, switch one to this switch, for example, fast Ethernet 01. Then from the switch to the router. Here we have to take care about the port that I will connect to the router from the router, from the switch F05 to the router gigabit 01. Here we take care about the ports because I will configure the ports in the router gigabit 01. Okay, guys, take care about this. So from the switch, I will use also the copper straight through cable. Yes, from gigabit 5, no problem for the fast for the port in the switch. But we take care about the port in the router. To router one in the gigabit. Zero. This is gigabit 01. This gigabit 00. Okay. In this part, not in this part, guys. Then I will do the same for the PC. For PC 2, and here normally here PC, PCB, I will connect it directly to the router to gigabit 00. This PC. This PC, I will connect it directly to the router. Here we can use a crossover cable because it's a computer to a router. But we can also use a straight through cable. What do you like? Crossover? Crossover, yes. Crossover from the Ethernet port of the computer to this router in the middle in the gigabit 00. Okay, guys, gigabit 00 and the router. Then I will connect PCC to switch 3 and switch 3 to router 3. We use the cable, copper straight through. From the third PC the fast Ethernet, then I go to this switch to fast Ethernet 01. No problem with the port for the switch. Then from the switch and the fast Ethernet 05. Of the switch, this one, then I will connect it to this router, router 3. Okay, and fast Ethernet, gigabit, sorry, 01, sorry, not 2, gigabit 01. I will remove this cable. I will reconnect it to gigabit 01. Okay, for the first router, to which port it was connected, guys? To gigabit 01 also, not 00. For the first router. Here, just I will rename the routers. This is R1. This S1 router R2 R3. Then S3 just here, guys, for the connection from S1 to gigabit 01. So I will reconnect the switch for this port. I will reconnect it to 01, because here, guys, if you connect it to another port, but you will configure the port gigabit 01, but you are not connected to 01, it will not work with you. Okay, normally I have now done the all connections. Just I will back to the logical topology and I have to arrange this gigabit 01. Yes, still an important thing, guys. What is it? The connection of routers to each other. So for the routers, which cable we use to connect routers? It has a name, the serial cable, guys. Normally, if I try to connect it and from between routers, and you see here in the topology, I have to connect R1 to R2 serial 00, and you have the DCE to inform us about the position of the clock rate. It will be from the side of router one. So if I try to do this with the serial cable, this DCE, and this is the DTE. The DCE, I try to connect it, but I don't have a port. So I need to add a port for serial ports. So if you try to connect it, you don't have the port. So what I will do first, I will click on each router, power it off. Then I will add a serial card to this slot, and to the right slot. But guys, better to add it to, you can add it to the left slot, this slot, but the correct number or the correct order of port numbers, you start from the right to the left. So I have to power it off first. Off. Now I will select the serial card. Normally is the HWIC2T. Then I will plug it in this slot, then power on. I will do the same for each router to get this routers ready to be connected to other routers. Or you can do like that, guys, drag and drop. Then power on. And the third router also, power it off, then add the serial port. Normally each card, serial card that you add contain two serial ports. For this reason, it is named 2T. The HWIC2 is a Cisco 2-port serial high-speed one interface card providing two serial ports. Now, power it on. Sometimes if you forget, power it powered off, and you try to configure your interface, it's still red. Even if you have the correct configuration, so you have to take care about this step. So now to connect routers to each other from R1, I use the DCE cable in the serial 00 to R2 in the serial 00. Then DCE, another serial DCE cable from 001 in router 2 to serial 001 in router 3. No connection between R1 and R3, direct connection between R1 and R3. So here I will use the serial cable to connect R1 to R3. This is the DCE. I will connect it to one of these parts. Just here I will increase, I will zoom in, sorry. To the serial 000, okay? Then I will go to router 2 to serial 00. This blue cable is the serial cable. Then another DCE from the serial port in the router 2 to the serial port 001. This one, guys, not this 00. This is the 001. Normally now I have connected all devices with the required cables. Just now I will back to the logical interface and you see here how they are connected. If you can't see the ports in your topology, go to options, preferences, and select this option, always show port and labels. If it's not selected, you will not see your ports. It's very important to know the ports because in the configuration, it will be easy for you to configure the correct parts. Always show port labels, it will be checked. Now, what we need to configure this device, the famous console cable. Okay, remember this, guys, the console cable from PC, for the PC is normally the RPC, APC, RS-232 to the router and the console port, not the auxiliary port, to the console port, guys. Then from this PC to router 2 and also for router 3 to the PC. Normally PCs, we have PCA, this is PC, sorry. PCB and PCC. Okay, now we have to start the configuration, but first I back to the instructions in my lab manual. You here, you will see for each router, you will configure the interfaces that connect the router to the switch and the interface that connect the router to other routers. And we'll start with router 1. But before this, you have to rename these routers. And this step, normally, configure basic settings for each router. This is what we have done in the last term. We will configure the router for the switch, shall we keep it for the lab? We have the lab concerning the VLAN, shall we take it next week? Here we have to disable the DNS lookup, configure the device name, configure the password encryption, the command service password encryption, assign class as a password for the privilege mode, assign Cisco as a password for the console port and VTY ports or lines, console line and the VTY lines. The banner method, the message that appear when you try to log in your switch, logging synchrony use here to avoid the conflict in the configuration when you configure your router or switch. Configure the IP address listed in the addressing table for all interfaces. Then configure the description. Interface will not do it for the description. Configure the clock rate and copy running configuration to which command? The famous command, copy run start, or copy running configuration start configuration. Okay, guys, we start with it. The lab not yet free. Ah, yes, but I think they didn't yet finish. Just I will start with the first router. Here, guys, also I have uploaded to make it easy for you, you know, this Ramadan Mubarak. So we make all things easy. You have in the lab folder the commands for the configuration of all routers. Just you have to route it correctly. And you understand what you wrote, guys. Okay. Normally, also you have some of this command here. For example, you see here the but here in this step, it goes directly to the configuration of the routing protocol RIP. The problem of the internet. Okay, just I will start from PCA. I will go to desktop. Terminal, okay. Then here, as you remember for the router, we have this yes or no questions. And some students, they put yes. As I told you, if you put, read what it asks. Would you like to enter the initial configuration dialogue? And you will see a dialogue between you and the router. To see, yani like to explain for you the steps for the configuration that exists in this route. But you need to configure your router. So you will put no, and you will start your configuration by pressing enter. We are in the which mode? The user exec mode. So I will use the command enable to go to the privilege mode. Then I will start with the first command for the configuration. Configure. Configure terminal. Okay. Configure terminal. The first command is hostname. Hostname R1. Then the encryption of the password. Service password encryption, or you can start by creating the passwords, then you encrypt them. But to avoid forgetting this encryption, put it from the beginning. Service password encryption. Then you will put the enable password, enable secret password. Okay, guys. Yes. Now you do it. You do it. Yes. Yes. As I told you guys, I will go with the steps that exist in the lab manual. But here, take care about the IPs. Here, guys, in the table that exists in the main file, here we have the IPs for each device. Take care about this IPs to be configured correctly. So I will go with the first router, the password that I have assigned the class. Then now I will access the configuration to the configure terminal. Then I will create the password for the line console, line console 0. Sorry, line console. I will start with the console, guys, first. Line console 0, password Cisco. This password, to make it active, I will. The NFC, I already done it. Okay. I will put login to activate it. And here we have the command concerning the login synchronous. Sorry, before this, guys, I will configure the VTY password, line VTY 024, the same password, Cisco, and 04, yes, for the VTY 04, for the router, because for the router, we have a few, like, remote access lines. The service password command, normally I already done it, but if you forget it, just you put service password encryption. Then, guys, I go to the command. For the command concerning the banner method. Remember it, guys, the banner method. Banner, you put the command banner, M2D, M-O-T-D, then you put hashtag, and you put your name and your ID. Okay. Yes. No problem. You can't do it, but it's better to do it from the beginning, guys. It's better to do it from the beginning. Guys, for the command concerning the loopback, because here it asks me about if you see this command. The first step, the disable the DNS lookup and the command concerning the logging synchronous. See, guys, these two commands, the disable the DNS lookup. To disable the DNS lookup, we use this command. And the router, I will put DNS. In the configuration mode, no IP domain. No IP domain then dash lookup. This to disable the DNS. IP domain lookup. Okay, this command, guys, please. For the second command that I think we have taken it last term, but also I hope you didn't forget it. The command concerning the logging synchronous. Logging synchronous, guys, we do it for the console part. So I have to access again to the line console zero, line console zero. Then I will put the command logging synchronous. So this to avoid that you receive this logging updates in the same line when you put your command. Yes, no IP domain lookup, and you press enter. Then line console zero to provide the configuration for the logging synchronous. Line C zero, C, console zero. Normally here, guys, I finish it with the first configuration for the security. Now I will exit and I will configure the interface. I will start with the interface gigabit zero that connects the router to the switch. The configuration of the gigabit 01 that connect the router to the switch and the IP address. So what I will do, I will put interface gigabit 0/1 IP address 172 based on the table, guys. Take care about this IPs should be in the same configuration or information given to you in the lab manual. And the lab manual, the gigabit 01.172.30.10.1. IP address 172.30.10.1. And the subnet mask, guys, 255.255.255.0. Then you put now shut down to activate it. And you will see here in your configuration, the color change from red to orange, or this means that you have configured this interface correctly. Now we have to configure the second interface, the serial 00. So I will use the same command, interface S0/0/0, IP address the same, 10.1.1.1.3 space, the subnet mask. Take care of the subnet mask, guys. 255.255.255.252, because this is /30, the prefix 252. Then press enter. The command now shut down. And because this is DCE, I will configure the clock rate. Clock rate, guys, is 56,000. The clock rate. Normally, I finish it with this router, but you see the IPs, the clock rate done. Copy running configuration. Yes, this is the last command. So I will put to exit. I will put end to back to the, because I do it in the privileged mode. I put end. Then I will copy running configuration to guys to rotate correctly. Copy running configuration to startup configuration. Then press enter. Then enter again to confirm. Now we finish with router one. I will go to router 2 through PCB, desktop, terminal. Okay. Okay, guys. Then I will press enter, enable, configure terminal. Then I will start with the same steps. Disable the NS lookup, guys. Now, IP domain dash lookup present. Then configure the service, the device name. Host name R2. Then configure the password encryption. Service password, sorry, service password encryption. Then I will go with the steps that exist, guys, in the manual to have this correct steps for this part. But the same, and you can do the commands not in the correct order, but it's better to go with this order to avoid any error, to forget any command. Configure the password encryption, service password encryption. Then assign a class with a privilege mode. Enable secret class. Then assign Cisco as a console password. So I have to access the line console 0 password Cisco as example. You can use admin, you can put any other password, but take care to forget this password. Okay. Then we have to configure the line VTY. But before this, guys, I will configure the logging synchronous for the line console. Logging synchronous. Then I will, for the password class, I will activate it. Login to activate the class password with the command login. Now I will go to line VTY. Line VTY 04, the same password, Cisco, then login to activate it. I finish with the line VTY and line console. I will go now, I will exit from this from the line configuration, and I will configure the IP address, sorry, the banner method, M2D, the hashtag, yes, 23, 24, and I close it, this message with hashtag. You can put any message, but here, guys, to put your ID to make it as authentication or to validate your submission, not the submission of another student. Banner method, I finished with the banner method. Now I will go to the configuring the IP addresses. So I will first go to the interface that connect my computer PCB to the router. Gigabit 00. So I will put interface or the abbreviation of this interface INT G0/0. Then IP address. The IP address, guys, take care about this IP. And the table is not the same as the previous one. 209.165.201.1. IP address 209.165.201.1 and the subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Then press enter. Now shut down to activate it. And you see it become green now when I do this command, the link. The interface is active. 00, yes. The same command and put the correct password, correct subnet mask. Then I have to configure the interface serial that connect, because this router too, guys, connect with two serial, a serial with router one and the serial with router three. But I will configure, you see here in the table, you have R2 serial 000 that connected to R1 and serial 001 that connected to R3. So I will put interface S0/0/0 that connect router 2 to router 1. And the IP address, 0.2, 10.1.1.2, is in the same network with router 1. The subnet mask 255.255.255.252. Then no shutdown. Okay, guys. The next command is
serial 001.
No, the serial 001. Yes, I will just upload the previous command, replace 000 by 001. Then the IP address for this interface 001. 10.2.2.2 and the subnet mask 255.255.255.252. Then press enter, and here also is a DCE, this interface, guys. So I will put clock rate 56,000. And I will put now shutdown. Now I finished the configuration of router 2. Yes. For which interface? 001, normally your in router 2 is a DCE. Just here, guys, I will put and I will copy 56,000. Copy running configuration to startup configuration. Okay. Now, guys, it's still for me the router 3. Ready, guys, for this configuration? I will copy it and send it to you because this router, I think we have made the all commands. Correctly, so I will copy this and send it to you. Yes. You will do it, but not now, at the end. After finishing the configuration of our routers, you back to do it. Yes, finish other routers, then we back to it. Yes. Yes, the same error. Huh? Now I will go to router 3, guys. Router 3, desktop, terminal. Okay, press enter. Enable, configure terminal. I will go with the same steps as before. No, IP domain. Yes, no IP domain lookup. Then configure the service, the host name R3, sorry. Then the configuration of the password encryption, service password encryption. Then we configure the enable secret password. As example, a class. Then configure the line console. So I will access the line console 0. Password Cisco, sorry, I put it Cisco. Then login to activate it. Then logging synchronous for the line console. And I will exit to go, I will go to the line VTY, without exiting because we are in the same level. Line VTY 04, the same password as I give it to the line console, Cisco, password Cisco, login to activate it. Then I will put exit and I will go to the banner method, MOTD. The message that I have to display in my access, my first access. No, it's the same, dash. Then I put this message as example. Sorry, I have to close it with the hashtag here. If you forget to close it, you have to put the hashtag to close this banner method. Then I will go to the configuration of the IP address. I will start with the interface. Gigabit 01. And its IP address from the table, gigabit 01.172.30.30.1. 172.30.30.1. And the subnet mask, 255.255.255.0. Then now shut down to activate it. And now the serial that connect router 3 to router 2, the serial 001. Interface S0/0/1. The IP address 10.2.2.1. Take care about this, guys. And the subnet mask 255.255.255.252. 252, guys. Then, because here no clock rate is DTE, so I will put now shutdown. And normally, here, the all routers are configured. And I finished the first part for the configuration. Just here, I will put end. Then I will copy the running configuration to startup configuration. Now I will go to the next part. Here it asks me to configure the PCs. I will assign the IP address for each PC based on the addressing table. This the addressing table, guys. And we have to assign this step 9, refer to the addressing table. Assign PCs information and normally is the IP address. For the PC A, this is the IP address. You can add copy it and you back to your topology, click on PC A, then close the configuration, the terminal for the configuration and go to the IP configuration. Then you paste your address or you wrote it. Then subnet mask. And here you have to assign the gateway. The gateway, guys, is based on the network where exists this PCA with gigabit 01 is the IP address of gigabit 01. Gigabit 01, it's IP 10.1.1.1. So I will put the gateway 10.1.1.1. This for PCA. Go to PCB. And also, I will go to the IP configuration. Then the IP address, as it exists in my addressing table for PCB 209.165.201.2. And take care, guys, about this IPs to put it correctly. Paste, then I will put this, the subnet mask, then the gateway. This gateway, guys, it is based on what? And the gigabit 00 IP. The gigabit 00 IP is, sorry, guys, for the IP address for PCA, which the gateway, guys? Yes, dot one, not 10.1.1. Take care about this, because the gateway should be in the same network address. Okay, so here for PCA, 172.30.10.1. Take care about this. For PCB, the IP address, it will be the same as the IP, but finish with one. Then for PCC, guys, the IP address for PCC. Yes. You, here, guys, in the last column, you have the gateway, guys. Take care about the, in the last column, you have the gateway.
I have to go to get my sister's. I have to go to get my sister's on brother from school. I already entered that with mother on the computer. Atom plus five.
Say that, say that. Yes?
Yes, because I did something wrong. I put it in the CLI. Is it wrong or what?
Not wrong, but don't do it again.
Okay.
Sit down, sit down, sit down. Just 1 minute.
هم طلعوا من الساعة 12 بس أنا كنت قاعدين في الكلاس.
Just one.
لازم أجيبهم.
Okay, just 1 minute. The gateway, guys, for the the IP address for the PCC 192.168.1.7.2.30.30.1 and the subnet mask.
Gateway.
Yes, the subnet mask, then the gateway 172.30.30.1. Okay. Just see what you do, guys, for to test the connectivity in the next step, because here it to use the simple PDU to test the connectivity. So here, if you try to test the connectivity normally from HPC to its directly connected router, you will get successful ping. Okay, PCA to router one, PCB to router two, and PCC to router three, successful ping. If you have here a successful ping, there is an error. Okay, guys. Just now, it's still for us the router configuration. But if I ping, guys, from PCA to PCB before configuring the routing table, from PCA to PCB, failed. Why? Because it's not in the same network. So I need to configure a routing protocol to guide packs from the next hop to the next network. So here, if I go to the first router terminal, okay, and I will check here. You see here the banner method, guys? It appeared to me. It asked me the password. It's the console password. Cisco, the line constant password. If I put enable, it asks me the enable secret password. No problem, it worked. It worked. Yes, crossover or slip through, it will work.
The PCB and the router too. Is it okay if we put it straight?
Yes, yes, yes. Here, just guys, I will quickly finish with the routing configuration, the RIP configuration in this 5 minutes before leaving. So here the command from the configure terminal, guys. We put the protocol router rib to activate this protocol, and we have to select the version because we have version 1 and version 2. Version 2, then I will put the passive interface, gigabit 01. Passive interface, guys, normally the router, when it creates its routing table, it will forward it to all ports. To all ports. Our router here, router 1, to which ports it was connected? It was connected to this network, to PC1, and to this network. I don't need to send the update to this PC because it's not useful. Yes or no? So here I will make this interface passive, so it will not receive the update. It only the update will go to the interface that are not passive, yani are active. Also, for security reasons, also avoid the routing table, go to this PC. It's possible in this PC there is a hacker. He can catch the specs related to your routing table. If you make it passive, so never the updates will be sent to this interface. Yani to all PCs that exist in this network here. So here, guys, if I highlight different networks that they have here, if you see, we have how many networks? This is the first network. Then this is the second network between router 1 and router 2. The third network between PC B and this router. The next network between router 2 and router 3. And the fourth network between router 3 and the PCC. Normally, router 1 know this network where exists PCA because it's connected to it. And it knows this blue network because it's directly connected. But didn't know this network where exists PCB, and didn't know the network where exists the network between router 2 and router 3, and didn't know the network between router, that exists between router 3 and PCC. So I have to inform this each router about the networks that are far from it, yani exist after one router, one hop. Yani I will advertise which networks, just if I need to highlight them. I have to advertise this network where exists PCA, PCB, sorry, this one, and this one, and this one. There's three networks. Here, just from PCA, I will inform about the router, about the network where exists PCA. This, PCC. PCC exists in this network. Yes. PCC exists in which network, guys? Just I will add the network address for each one. This one, the IP address 172.30.10. Yes or no? The first PC, PC, PCA, .10.3, yani .10.0/24. This network here, 209.165.201.0/24. This network between router 1 and router 2, 10.1.1.1 sorry, dot zero. لا نتورك، نتورك فينيش ويز زيرو، بات هير دوت ساش 30 فور ذا نتورك بيتوين راوتر 2 وراوتر 3 10.2.2.0 سلاش 30 اند ذا نتورك وير اكزيست بي سي بي سي سي 172.30.30.0 سلاش 24 just 10 minutes for the router PCA. Yeah, sorry. Go to PCA to continue with the configuration. I will advertise the router about the network where exists PCC 10. That, sorry, 172.30. So I will put the command network. Please, guys, you are ready. Network 172.30.0.0. Why, guys, I didn't put dot 30? Because the two networks here, see this network, it starts with 172.30.10.0. This network starts with 172.30.30.0, which the common bytes. The two first bytes, we name this summarization to avoid to create each one independently. I create one that summarize both of them. So I will put 172.30.0. Okay. And for the network between routers, 10.1.1.0. And this network between router 2 and router 3, 10.2.2.0, which the summarization? 10.0.0.0. So this makes the size of the routing table small when you use the, that name summarization. So here what we do, network address, just here I will put 10.0.0.0. Normally I finish with this router. Yes, passive interface, guys, here. The command for the passive interface. Passive interface, gigabit 0/1. I will go and do the same for router. Yes, yes, go, go. For router two, we will configure, guys, for the router two. Terminal. Okay. Password here for the console password, Cisco. Enable class. Is this for router two? Yes, guys. For router two, we configure the command for, sorry, configure terminal for first. Then router, router rip, version two. And here we will configure the network, because which networks outside of router, two, guys? We configure 10.0, sorry, network first. We put the command network 10.0.0.0. Then we use the command default originate. This command, guys, you will see it will send a copy from this famous root. See this root, guys, IP root. So here I will put exit first. This is a static root, guys. To PCB root. You remember, guys, the command for configure static root, IP root. Then 0.0.0.0, the IP address, the subnet mask, 0.0.0.0. And the next hop is 205, 209, sorry, dot 165. Dot 201.2. Yani here, like any packet that router 2 can't find a path to it, it will be forwarded to this default route that we name is the default route 0.0.0 space 0.0.0.0. The last router, guys, please. Sorry for this timing, Allah Musta'an. You see, sometimes we are pushed to this situation. Terminal, okay. Which is the password? Cisco. Here for the enable, for the console password, Cisco, console password. Enable. Enable password. Plus. Then configure terminal. I will do the same for the two routes, but the possible interface, so guys, here. First, I will go to router rib, version 2, then passive interface gigabit 01 also from the side of the PCB here. I will make this interface as a passive interface. Then I will advertise the networks, network 172.30.0.0, the same as before. And the network for the networks between routers, 10.0.0. Network 10.0.0.0. Okay. Then here, guys, I will put exit. Yes, yes, you have.
After the default information of
Originate. These guys, you do it at the level of the router 3, default originate. But in the router rip, but you put exit, then you configure the default route. Okay, default route, guys, is a static route. The default route. Where? Just, where is it? Where is it?
The router 2 configuration, the last one.
The router 2 configuration. Here, guys. First, you have to access the router rip. Yes. Network 10.0.0. Then you put default originate. Then you put IP route after exit. And here you will put exit after default originate. You put exit, guys. Okay. Here, by mistake, not exist. So here you put exit, sorry, in this part. You tape it. Yes. Yes.
Not zero.
Huh? The IP route 4 zeros, space 4 zeros. Here the default route, guys. Now just I will check the routing tables. I will put exit and I will put the command. Before this, I will copy the running configuration to startup configuration. Running configuration to startup configuration, sorry. Then I will use the command show IP route. You see here, guys, this, the two routes for the 10.1.1.0. And here the cost. And here via 10.2.2. Two, yani the next hop interface, and the second route to reach the network where exists PC, where exists PCA, the 172.30.0.0, and the next the exit interface, sorry, the next hop 10.2.2.2, and see this route, guys, with asterisk R with asterisk, this it means the default route that. If the router receive a packet without knowing path that exists in the routing table, it will be forwarded to this default route. Just here, I will put, and then I will copy the running configuration to a startup configuration, show IP route, sorry. You see the same, guys. We have two RIP routes. One between router 2 and router 3, and one where exists PCC. And this is the default route for PC, PCB. Also, if I do for this, now I will test the connectivity. Before, when I test the ping, guys, field. If now I try to do the ping from PCA, I will start with the order from PCA to router one, then from PCA to router two. You see here, it said in progress. Then I click again, it will be successful. Then from PCA to PCB, successful. Then from PCA to router three. Just I will click again, it will be successful. Then from PCA to PCC. Okay. Now, if I ping from any PC, after configuring the routing protocol, it will ping successfully between all PCs. Okay, guys, this the configuration for the RIP. Sorry for this time. You know, I think the situation. Just what else here? I will back to the configuration if there is anything. Here it asked me from PCA, click connectivity here when we do the first configuration, guys, about before configuring the routing protocol. When issuing the debug rip command, here if I use the commands before the configure the routing protocol. But I will share, you have the solution, guys, here because of the time. You have the solution for this question, but in general, normally when you configure this command, guys, you see here in the router one, I will add this command, just this command, guys, sorry. It's see this command, please. Router rip, no auto summary to give the network address for each network. Just I will do it here, sorry. I will go to configure terminal. Then I will put the command in the router rip protocol version 2. Then I will put no auto summary. This command, guys, will show us each network with each complete address. Then I will put the command to activate this. If I put here, and I will show the IP route, you see it's still at the same. I need here to use this command, clear. Yani here you need to reload your computer, your router. What I do, first I will copy the running configuration to startup configuration. Then I will apply this command to clear the routing table. Clear. IP route. Yes, this guys will show you that like you reconfigure how routers detect other routers. First, when I do this command, no auto summary, it will keep everything as the same as before. But I need to reload or to restart my router to get this information. So now, if I put the command show IP route, you will see for, it will be, you see this two networks. I will do it, you see, for the routing table, but I have to do it for also for router three. Configure terminal. Router rip version 2 and no auto summary. Then I will put and copy the running configuration to startup configuration. Then clear. Yes, yes. What's your question? Clear IP route.
you put the asterisk. Okay, then you will put show IP root. Yes. See now, not exist because I do it. I do the command show IP root quickly immediately after doing this command. The update, it need more time to appear. So you see here after this show, we don't have any IP root. RIP root, yani routing information protocol root. But if I do it again after fast forwarding, it will receive the updates. You see now the updates, guys. Clear, and it will remove the old routing table and apply this command auto summarize it, which the service. And you see here it show us now the all routes as I have done before. And if I back here, also I do it again in this router, it show us all this routes.
Clear IP route, then what's the key?
Asterisk Najm.
Oh, Najm.
Okay, guys. One command, guys, here is an important command, is the command show RIP, show IP protocols. To show which, and the question, which protocol you have used. Show IP protocols. It will show you, guys, see here, which the protocol, routing protocol is RIP. And you will see here the sending updates every 30 seconds. This is the updates. And you, because before when I do the command, immediately after the clear table, it didn't show me the updates because I do it before 30 seconds. But when I do it again, it show me the configuration because it takes this time. And here, which routing networks? We have the network 10.0.0 and the network 172.30, passive interface gigabit zero, and the distance. See here the distance, guys. Distance is 120. Okay. Okay, guys. Ready to submit? So you will get the link, and you will get until Sunday to submit to Saturday midnight to submit your PackTracer file. Okay. Who they finish it? They can't submit it. We have the link. I think I have already added the link. Not yet. I will add it now, and you can add it. Yes. Lab 7, RIP. Let's go operate together, guys.